If you care at all about your security and privacy, the number one question you need to ask yourself before downloading any free VPN is this. In this world, you get what you pay for, but if you're looking for a free VPN, I'm not gonna stop you. I am, however, going to warn you about the dangers, what you can expect, and of course, give you recommendations on the very few services that I would even consider using. Welcome to All Things Secure. My name's Josh, and I've been using VPNs for over a decade now to bypass censorship, stream content, and of course, add that extra layer of security when I'm on an untrusted network. Now, there's a lot that I think's important for you to understand before you download and use a free VPN. But if you're strapped for time and you just want to connect, open up the App Store on your Windows, Mac, iOS, or Android device and search for Atlas VPN. You literally download, open the program, and click connect. You don't have to create an account, but you are limited to only 3 server options and fairly slow speeds. That alone is worth a simple like on this video, right? Just hit that like. But hold on, if you care about your security and privacy at all, the number one question you need to ask yourself before you download any free VPN is this: how are they making money? Because trust me, there is no company in the market today that is paying developers, investing in marketing, and renting servers all across the globe as a service for the good of humanity. Nope, they make their money somehow. Paid VPNs do it through subscription fees, but free VPNs are often more sneaky about their income. Some of them are paid to deploy malware on user devices, which means that the moment you download their software, you've been infected with additional malicious code. Other free VPNs track and sell your data to third-party companies, and before you say something dumb like, "I have nothing to hide," please understand that your identity is both valuable and costly to lose, so don't be foolish about it. The only type of free VPN that I recommend to people are those that run on what's known as a freemium model. What this means is that they can offer the free service because the costs are covered and offset by their paid customers. And in order to make that worthwhile for them, they often put restrictions on the free versions, including data caps, speed caps, limited server options, limited protocol options, limited feature options, and so on and so on. The freemium model allows you to try out the software, but it gives the company the leverage to push you towards their paid offering. And this is good because it satisfies the question we asked earlier, which is, how does this free VPN make money? Now that we're clear on that, I'm going to share with you the only 3 VPNs I feel comfortable recommending here on All Things Secured, including the limitations you'll run into with each of them. First, as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, there's Atlas VPN. I love the fact that you don't have to create an account to get started and that I was successfully able to stream Netflix when connected. There are no data caps here either. However, you'll be limited to only 3 servers, 2 in the US and 1 in the Netherlands. The speeds are enough to stream a show in my experience, but the quality wasn't great because it was still too slow. You're stuck with an older IPsec encryption protocol, but to be fair, they don't offer other options on the premium plan either. My number 2 recommendation for a free VPN comes from a company that also happens to make my favorite secure email alternative to Gmail, Proton. As far as security goes, I like Proton VPN more than Atlas because they use the standard OpenVPN protocol for their encryption. They also give you 7-day free access to their Premium Plus plan, which includes options for both Tor over VPN, as well as a double VPN feature they call Secure Core. Once that 7-day trial expires, though, your free account will only give you 3 location options, slower speed, no torrent support, and it doesn't work on streaming services like Netflix. Proton as a company has a great reputation, and like I said, their secure email product is my favorite. Their free VPN service doesn't feel like a good long-term option to me, but then again, I don't think any of these services are a great long-term solution. Finally, my last recommendation is TunnelBear. This is the quintessential example of a freemium model because they even tell you on the sales page that the purpose is for testing and limited usage. The biggest limit here is the cap on data, which is set at 500 megabytes. Nowadays, that's honestly not going to get you very far, but again, you're getting what you pay for. I like the fact that you can download TunnelBear knowing with a high degree of confidence that their business model is simply trying to get you to pay for their service, not to sell your data or install some malware on your device. Is a free VPN even worth downloading? Well, if your purpose is to test out VPNs or to use it for a very short period of time, then sure. I can safely recommend these options to you. But if you're trying to unblock streaming content or you have even the slightest desire to maintain privacy and security in the long term, you're eventually going to want to pay for the service. It's not that expensive, and now you know for sure how the business is making money. Well, what do you think? Is a free VPN worth the risk and the limitations? Let me know in the comments below and click that subscribe button to stay current on the latest security trends and privacy tips.